Utah's mayoral election isn't until next year, but Mayor Jean Stothert says she'll run again. It would be her fourth term. Stothert made the announcement today. She wants to see development projects through the end. And she cited a drop in Omaha's crime rate since 2022.
We've expanded the gang unit. We've done a lot with our mental health co-responder program. We added a new precinct out in Elkhorn. We've done things that have been talked about for years and years and years, and that is all showing with these low crime rates now.
Douglas County Treasurer John Ewing, a Democrat, will challenge Stothert. Again, that election, not until May of next year.
A major construction project starts next week in Omaha, and it won't end until fall of next year.
So it affects the bridge over South 72nd Street, and businesses are already bracing for the impact. KETV NewsWatch 7's Jessica Perez spoke with them. She joins us live.
People in this area know that progress takes patience, but this will take over a year's worth of patience. Now, this project will focus on this bridge behind me, and Public Works says it's old and in need of repairs.
On a regular day, South 72nd Street can get pretty busy. With construction work set to start on the bridge in April, businesses in the area expect to see a lot of congestion.
It's an integral part of the city, so that's going to be tough to watch.
During the first phase, 72nd Street northbound will be closed at L Street for through traffic. Northbound 72nd Street will be closed from F to I-80. It's expected to last until the end of the year. The second phase will start in early 2025 and go through fall. During this phase, 72nd Street traffic will have one lane open to traffic in each direction through the construction zone. Bill Marion says this could become a hassle for the semi-trucks frequenting the businesses nearby.
I mean, I hate to look outside and see 30 trucks are sitting there trying to get in their parking lot, but again, what do you do?
He owns Billmore Landscape and Pool on F Street. Ryan Denton, who services semis at Thermo King, says things are already chaotic without construction.
Especially if we get someone up to the gate and then all of a sudden you have two or three more big 53-foot semi trucks and trailers waiting to get in, it can already get backed up. It's only going to get worse when there's only one lane.
For Brad Samway, the construction will mean changing his daily commute.
Now I got to get off on 84th and then try to get over clear to the left.
A difficult task in morning traffic. But another goal of the project is to reduce future traffic congestion along South 72nd. Marion says this improvement will be worth it.
I understand progress takes patience, so we'll bear with it. We'll just start a little bit earlier in the morning, beat the traffic, and work till we get the job done.
You can find the recommended detours under this story at KETV.com. Live in Omaha, Jessica Perez, KETV NewsWatch 7. Okay.